are you doing?
My name's Naomi Ackie.
And my name's Kelly Marie Tran. And we're at NASA's Johnson Space Center. Mm-hmm.
And we're training to be astronauts.
No big deal.
No, not big deal at all. We got this.
Come on, let us do it.
Let's go.
The first thing we're going to show you this morning is what's called a gravity offload system. So people often think that we have a room here where you can go in and flip a switch and suddenly you're floating. That's not really how it works.
You want to see how it works when you're 1/6 your weight or 3/8 your weight? We use Argos to do that. And then we use it to work on like new tools, new geology, sampling procedures.
So from here, what we do, we'll lift you up off the ground.
Oh my God!
And we'll put you into lunar gravity. All right, so this right here is zero gravity. So if you're on a space station and I were to push you and say, see ya, you're just gonna put it away the way I push you.
So what did you guys think of that?
It was so cool. I was saying I realize now why astronauts walk like this.
Yeah!
Because everyone's just like trying as much as possible.
Do you guys want to go check out suits?
Yeah!
Want to go try some on?
So we're going to talk to you a little bit about spaces today.
Yeah.
We're going to move some suits over here, I think, real quick, and we'll talk to you a little bit about what they are, and then we're going to let you guys change and actually try some out.
So you go out there, and there's no air. Mm-hmm. So then there's pressure pushing in on your body.
So what we would have to go through is your body would want to expand out, so that's why we wear a suit around us that goes through and creates an artificial atmosphere.
Do you guys have training in terms of how quickly you can get in and out of these? Is that a thing or not?
No, like, I mean, you have to know your spacesuit really well, but we don't do drills like getting in them quickly. You typically are helping each other getting into and out of them when you're in space.
And so those tubes actually are going to create holes that help us cool. We'll see what that feels like once you get inside. These guys are going to help you get climb in.
Yeah,
like
Chewy.
With the guy who plays Chewbacca.
Stand up.
Well, unfortunately, we're going to get you guys out of the suit now, but then we're going to take you over and just see the vehicle that you would be in these suits in.
Okay.
The Orion vehicle.
This is the space launch system. This is what's going to push this capsule. This is the Artemis 1. This is going to go to the moon about 1 year from now.
Yes.
Did you see those? Oh my gosh.
Yes.
Okay. Nine.
This is the docking hatch up here. When we get to the gateway, we will dock at that port, and there will be a hatch up there that we open to go into the gateway.
Which you have to target, right? So you have to figure out a way to drive the rocket so that the holes match up.
Bingo. You know how precise it is? First of all, relative to the Earth, we're going over 20,000 miles an hour. And when we dock, meet up with this plus or minus one degree in each axis.
Really difficult.
Yeah, we actually make the switches. It's a multi-step, so you don't accidentally hit a switch.
We're gonna go check out the mock-ups for the space station, which will seem luxuriously large.
Okay. This gives you an idea of how big of a room each person gets, so you can put up your personal
suits.
You have a sleeping bag, as they mentioned, and you can pin that to the wall, and you can float kind of inside your sleeping bag.
That
you can
so
tighten
cool.
it down if you would like to feel a little bit more stable.
This is Houston.
Yes.
This is when they actually say, Houston, we have a problem. This is Houston.
So that's live.
They're in space right now.
What are they doing?
Oh my gosh, it's mad.
What's the day-to-day like in this room?
Yeah.
So in this room, we have 3 shifts a day. My favorite shift is the night shift because it's when nobody's in this building, but we get to hang out with the crew.
Are you guys ready to try some space for you?
Yes.
That's next on the list.
Where do you get the suggestions of what to work on next?
That's a great question. We get a lot from the crew office. Or the crew office says, can we move away from red meat and potatoes and get Brussels sprouts, butternut squash? And this comes from a lot of crew comments, as well as input from the nutrition line here at JSC that says, you guys should probably go with the salt in there. So on station, the astronauts have a much more advanced dehydration apparatus.
Okay.
They have the potable water dispenser. The astronauts can help you with figuring out how to unlock the straw.
Release this.
Great.
Otherwise, so that way when you set it down, liquid's not going to come up on the app.
Stuff is at the bottom, so you want to like.
Right. She knows the tricks. The tricks of the trade. Yeah.
Which one is your favorite?
I would say the butternut squash is my favorite. I like things that are sweet.
Mm-hmm.
I like the Brussels sprouts, I think. Mm. They're so good.
All right, well, you guys have had your afternoon snack. Now you're ready to go drive a lunar rover?
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's go check
it out. I really don't know how to drive. Is this like going to be a
challenge?
Oh.
What is that? Oh, it's a car. It's air conditioned.
It's air conditioned?
Twist.
Yep.
This is so cool.
On the lunar surface, it'll basically be, you're in the rover, like Meghan and Jessica will be in the rover for up to 14 days, living together. And there'll be another rover, they'll go out for 14 days and explore. And if one breaks down, all four of you will jump in one vehicle.
I think I made contact. I think we're there.
Awesome.
Yeah.
That was
nice.
Smooth.
Yes. That was awesome.
Dude, what an amazing day.
It's been really good. It's been amazing. It's more than I expected.
Yeah.
I just have so much respect for NASA.
Same.
Yeah. Thank you for bringing
us
NASA. Here.